Hello and welcome to the series of dynamic array functions in Excel. Filtering data is a common task in Excel, and it can be done manually or with the help of a filter formula. In this video, we will explore how to use filter formula to extract data from large datasets. This we will learn in detail through the following steps. First, what is the filter formula or function? Second, understand the syntax of filter's function. Third, detailed explanation with the examples. Fourth, how to use and condition and/or conditions in a filter. And fifth, what are the benefits of using filter function? And how does it differ from manually filtering data? So first, what is a filter formula? The filter formula is a function that allows you to extract specific data from a range of cells based on certain criteria. These criteria can be based on text, numbers, dates, or other conditions. The filter formula is also known as the filter function, and it was introduced in Excel 365. Now let's go to Excel to understand the filter syntax. In Excel, this function can be found in the Formulas tab, in the Function Library, under the Lookup and Reference group. You can access it by clicking on it. Or simply type equal to, filter, open parenthesis, and you will see the filter syntax. It includes three arguments, array, include, and if underscore empty. Array and include are required arguments, while if underscore empty is an optional argument since it is enclosed in square brackets. This means that it is not required for the function to work properly. To understand it better, let's click on this function sign, and it will open a dialog box, function arguments. Here, the array and then include are bolded, which indicates they are required arguments. While if underscore empty is in a normal format, which indicates it is an optional argument. Here, the reference refers to a cell, range of cells, or named range of cells, that the function will use as an input. The any indicates that we can define what to write if any of the conditions are not met. Clicking inside the argument, Excel provides a brief description of the argument here, which can assist you in understanding the purpose of the specific argument. Like for the array argument, we have to provide the range or array to filter. For the include argument, we can define the criteria or condition which we want to apply to filter the data selected in the array argument. And for if underscore empty, we can specify the value to return if the filter does not match any data in the array. As an example, let's filter the data for customer 1 into this range. To do that, as an array argument, we need to select the entire table. Now for the include argument, select the entire row that will be used for filtering. After that, equal sign, and specify what we are looking for, that is customer 1 in the double inverted comma. The moment we close the double inverted comma, it will reflect the result here, which is blank at the moment. Once you click OK, the data that contains sales data for customer 1 is filtered. Using Format Painter, let's copy the format. Now let's try filtering which is not available in this table and see what happens. When customer 1 is changed to customer 6, instead of showing the result here, it displays the formula, which represents the error. You will see the error after clicking OK. When you click on the error sign, it displays the type of error, that is display array. In this case, you can use if underscore empty argument. If the data not available for the filter we applied, display no record found. Besides using the equals sign in the include argument, you can also use the less than and greater than signs if the column contains dates or values. For example, let's change the customer name column to unit price. Then we can specify the filter, like records with unit prices greater than 200, and it will filter the data accordingly. Less than 200, etc. This is how the filter function can be used to extract specific data from a range. Now let's learn how to use and condition and or condition in a filter function. Filter formulas use them to create more complex logical conditions for filtering data, where we can specify multiple conditions with respect to multiple columns. In order to better understand it, I have included the drop-down lists, which we will use in the filter formula. For example, we have records for 31 dates, 5 customers, and 10 products in the dataset. The same options are included in the drop-down lists. Now let's add the filter formula here. Rather than typing the date manually, we will make it dynamic using a drop-down cell reference. Consequently, if you change the date from the drop-down, the result range will be updated accordingly. In the same formula, we will add and condition for the customer name column. And conditions are created using an asterisk sign between two conditions in the include argument. Let's add the second condition and see what happens. The result is a value error. Because, whenever you are using more than one condition, it is necessary to enclose each condition within the brackets. Let's add brackets and see what the result looks like. The AND condition displays the records if all conditions are met. In this case, only one condition matches the date and name of the customer. When we change the date, three records match. Now let's see the OR conditions. OR conditions are created using a plus sign between two conditions in the include argument. In this case, let's replace the asterisk sign with the plus sign and see the results. So the OR condition displays the records if at least one condition is met. Here it displays all the records from the second date and all records from customer 1. We can also add more conditions to the filter function. As an example, let's add the third condition for the product column. In this case, the data will be displayed only if all the conditions are met. Similarly, we can do the same for the OR condition. This case will display the data if one or more conditions are met. Now, let's see if we can use both conditions in one formula. Let's simplify our data so we can understand it better. We will just keep 10 records here and modify formula accordingly. As we have used the OR conditions in the formula, there are three records for each condition. When we replace first plus sign with the asterisk sign, it displays only one record. In this case, these conditions are not met, and it displays this record for this condition only. But here, if we select customer 1, it will display two records since all the conditions are met. Now, let's exchange the both signs in the formula. As you can see, it displays the record for this condition, whereas these conditions are not met. So it is clear that, if both conditions are used in the filter function, the AND condition will be evaluated first, that is asterisk sign. And then OR condition, that is plus sign. Lastly, let's see what happens if we use two conditions in the same column. We will try to filter the records for customer 1 and customer 2. So let's modify the formula accordingly. Therefore, using AND condition in the same column will not produce any results. On the other hand, if we use OR condition, it will display records for both customer 1 and customer 2. As we have discussed the filter function in detail, let's look at some of its benefits and advantages over manual filtering. With the filter formula, you can quickly display only the data you want without manually filtering. If you need to create reports for different audiences from the same dataset, the filter formula can be used to extract different datasets according to the needs of different audiences from the same dataset. Filter formulas can be combined with other formulas and functions to create dynamic filters that automatically update as data changes. Filter formulas are not limited to filtering data in tables or ranges, they can also be used to filter data from other workbooks or external databases. A filter formula is dynamic and automatically updates itself whenever the data changes, whereas manual filters require the user to update the filters every time the data is changed. The filter formula is portable, which means that it can be copied and pasted into other worksheets or workbooks. Overall, the filter formula provides more flexibility, customization, and automation compared to the manual filter in Excel. The tutorial is now complete, and we will see you next time. Thank you for watching.